Thank you, Jesus. Jesus said to those folks, why stand ye idle all the day? This is not acceptable. This is not the way to live. You are here in the marketplace where there's opportunity for everybody, and you are laying about. This is an eyesore. Somebody here was a sales fellow and carried his product on his shoulder, walking through the marketplace. And then a top official of the company producing that goods came by. Excuse me, how are you doing with the product? He markets the product very well. The man said, see me in the office tomorrow. I work in this company. From there, I became a sales manager. Amen. He carried that thing. He couldn't have become a sales manager in his room. He carried that on his shoulder in the marketplace, a graduate, and favor met him. 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 You must not be found on your mother's lap upon leaving school. It's an insult to your training. It's an insult to your redemption. No, you must not. You must not stay somewhere where they're asking, have you eaten, or where you are determining what to eat when you are not working. Shouldn't. It's not normal. It's not normal. It's not normal. That's an abnormality. Don't try it. Amen. None of your parents here will regret over you. Dash me is what dashes destiny. Wealth gotten by vanity shall diminish, but he that gathers by labor shall increase. No matter what parents leave for their children, it does not add to their worth. It's the product of the work of their hand that enhances their value. That's why many great names left great wealth behind and they were wrecked in a moment. Can't find them anymore. Because wealth must be produced, not received. It's produced by taking responsibility, covenant responsibility, practical responsibility. Your parents' accomplishments are not transferable to you. They are not. If your dad is a professor of mathematics and he will the certificate to you and you try to apply somewhere with that certificate, you will end up in jail. You can even produce the paper, the affidavit, that your father used to transfer it to you, and it asked you, do you think qualification and experience are transferable? You say, well, I don't know, my father gave me, okay. You and your father, you answer in the prison. When you go to the prison, tell your father in heaven that you're in the prison by the inheritance he gave you. It doesn't add up. If your father were a wrestler, a world-class wrestler, a world champion wrestler, and then he left his belt for you as your heritage, and somebody invites you to challenge your title, and you try to go there. Amen. When he takes you up, you ask, where do you want to die? Outside the court or in the court? Speak now, because I'm going to break you to pieces now. And then he throws you down, your hand will go one way, your leg will go one way, because you are not equipped for it. You are not equipped for it. That's how worthless inheritance can be. That's how worthless inheritance can be. It does not add up. It doesn't enhance value. It doesn't enhance worth. I promise you, 8 on the dot, lift up your two hands.